Most people in America are familiar with what is and isn't lawful. When a person is invaluable to society, they often become homeless. Now, when I say that, am I really meaning they're invaluable to God's house, or am I meaning that people have simply decided they're invaluable in some way, shape, or form? That can take a toll on a person's psyche. That can certainly cause some emotionality, and that can also make someone sad or possibly depressed. In my case, I'm not ever depressed. The truth is, I might be sad on occasion, missing the one I love, but that's my right. I also might be sad to miss my Japanese family, but that too is my part of the grieving process, the transitional process from being a family man to a single man, and then hopefully, in a few moments of time, and God's timing, the family man again. In life, we have moments of time to speak the truth about value, and a person who is valuable is never stealing or thieving from anyone. A person that is valuable to someone knows what the rules of America are. A person that is valuable to our nation knows what the laws are. A person that is valuable to their company regards the law with regard to their position. In other words, what is their areas of accountability and what are their duties that they're responsible for? You see, responsibilities and duties are sometimes the same and sometimes different. You are responsible for keeping your company's brand name. You are responsible for keeping your company's customer service policies. You are responsible for keeping your cool when you're on the job because you never know who is watching you, from a security camera in your main corporate office and headquarters to the local people who are behind that individual in a line, smiling at you or supporting you or simply going, "I cannot believe they employed this guy." In America, we also have duties, and duties are the things that we perform on the job. Any retail employee's sole single job is to move product through that store. Moving product through the store is based on the corporate headquarters agreement with different vendors of million-dollar capacities, meaning those contracts that those salesmen and those executives and those shareholders have negotiated are what you're moving through that store. Do not underestimate your job. Your job is to protect the assets of your store. You don't do that by being vigilant against people that you think are the problem, because typically speaking, what we know from most of these folks is they couldn't spot a thief if their money depended on it. You see, your money is the money that that company pays you to perform your duties every day. Your number one job is to collect income for your company, not at all. You're collecting revenue for your corporation. When you collect the payment for a product, you're collecting revenue for the business, for the model, for the type of organization you serve. When you do your job and do your duties well, you receive an income, and that's your hourly wage. Am I making myself clear that that is how you're earning your keep? That's how you're earning your livelihood, and that is how you're earning your three S's: your shelter, your sustenance, and your services. The things that you need to live in this world.